What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and we're gonna have another podcast, second one this week, and we're filming this almost right after the NFL draft concluded, and we're just gonna be giving our thoughts and some team grades for what we think everyone did. So, just gonna get started here.
Yeah, first up, we got the Arizona Cardinals. I gave their draft grade a B. I didn't like their first round pick, Zaven Collins. I think he's a good linebacker, but they took him way too high. I did like Ronald Moore, though. He's a pretty good wide receiver. And Marco Wilson, great DB.
All right, I'm gonna give the Cardinals a B plus. I liked the Zaven Collins. I mean, still a good player. I like that pick. And then Rondale Moore, obviously he's a good player too. But I mean, they just signed AJ Green this offseason, so now they have four wide receivers. So I didn't think they used that pick like to the best of its ability, but they addressed most of their needs.
Next, we got the Falcons. I gave them an A. I like the Kyle Pitts. Most people thought that they should have traded back, but he was the best player available, and they took him. Now that offense is actually insane. They took great safety, Richie Grant. He was actually a steal in the second round. I like that pick a lot. And they really filled in their depth in the later rounds, so I gave their draft an A.
Yeah, I'm gonna give the Falcons an A minus. I thought Kyle Pitts is obviously the best player available, even though they don't really necessarily need a bunch of offensive talent like that. He's still, I mean, that's pretty much gonna make their offense almost unstoppable in the red zone, which they definitely struggled with last season. And throughout the later rounds, they helped out their defense by, and they also lost Keanu Neal and DeMonte Kazee, so they needed some depth there and they picked that up. So I think they have a pretty solid defense now.
For the Ravens, I gave them an A. I think their first round pick was great, Rashad Bateman. I think he's really underrated in this draft. And next, they went with an outside linebacker, Owe. I thought he was a first round talent, so that was a steal in the second round. And they went offensive line and bought a bunch of other spots that they needed in the later round, so they had a really great draft.
All right, the Ravens, I'm gonna give an A also. Their first day of the draft, I'd say they had the best first round out of any team. Bateman, very underrated receiver and great for Lamar Jackson. And Jason Owe, another great addition for their defense. So they solid first two picks there. And then the rest of the 2 days, they were pretty average. I mean, they filled some needs, but they had a really good draft.
For the Bills, I gave them a B plus. I like their first round pick, but really besides that, I think they kind of reached on the rest of their picks. But it wasn't that bad. It was still a pretty good draft.
I'm also gonna give the Bills a B plus. I liked the Rosso pick in the first round because they really need helping their front seven. The Basham pick was interesting. I don't think that was the best use of their pick, but they also helped out their O-line in the later rounds, and they picked up a few secondary pieces, so they had a decent draft, but it wasn't like anything special.
For the Panthers, I give them an A. I think J.C. Horn was a great pick at 8. I wanted Fields, but Horn is still great. We needed another corner. We really traded back like every single time. So we had a pretty loaded draft. I think we got some steals though with Chuba Hubbard in the fourth, Brady Christensen in the third round. Those were great draft picks too.
I'm gonna give the Panthers an A minus. I like the J.C. Horn pick. That's definitely gonna help their secondary. And Terrace Marshall, I think he's a good addition. Obviously, he's a good player, but that definitely wasn't their biggest need. So that's sort of a holdback on them. But after that, they had really good picks. Obviously, Chuba Hubbard was a him and McCaffrey are gonna be a really good duo eventually. And after that, they're just helping out some depth, so.
I give the Bears an A. I think Justin Fields was an A plus pick, probably the biggest steal of the first round. and they went right back in the second round. They got Tevin Jenkins. He was a first round talent, and they really filled some holes in the later rounds. So that was a really great draft.
I'm also going to give the Bears an A. Justin Fields, I was really don't think anybody was expecting them to trade up to do that, but it's a very bold move of Ryan Pace to do that, with a lot of the fans being frustrated with him recently. And also Tevin Jenkins, that was an absolute steal in the second round. They were just making really good picks all around. Towards the Daz Newsome, I didn't really agree with that pick. I think they could have done something better with that. But other than that, they had a really good draft.
I'm gonna give the Bengals a B plus. A lot of people didn't like the Ja'Marr Chase pick. I thought it was fine, but people thought they really should have gone offensive line with Slater or Sewell. But they did address O-line in the second round and the later rounds, and they signed tackles in the offseason, so I thought it was fine. But their draft was still pretty good, so I gave them a B plus.
Bengals, I'm gonna give a B. Ja'Marr Chase, obviously not the worst thing that could happen to them, but I think they should have taken Penn A. Just, I mean, they already have Boyd and Higgins, and I think that's good enough for Burrow. It's gonna be, and especially with young guys, it's tough to, like, when you have three guys like that, it's hard to, like, share, like, the load or whatever. So. And of course, he doesn't have really an O-line right now, so they definitely could have used better picks for that, but average draft, I'd say.
For the Browns, I give them an A. I thought Greg Newsome was great value that they got him that late in the first round. And then they went on the second round and got JOK, who was a first-round talent who fell to them, luckily, in the second round. And throughout the later rounds, they went on offensive line, linebacker. They really filled all their holes here. So great, it was a great draft by them.
All right, I'm also going to give the Browns an A. The Greg Newsome pick was a very good pick for them, because Denzel Ward was really all they had, so now they're going to be one of the best cornerback duos in the league. JOK falling out of the first round. He's had, reportedly had some heart problems, but I mean, second round, I feel like they had to, somebody had to take him, so I think, and the Browns really need linebackers, so I think that was a pretty good pick. And yeah, the rest of the draft, they're really just filling in depth of where they needed the most people.
Cowboys, I gave them a B plus. They kind of got screwed in the draft a little bit with the all three corners that they wanted all going right before them. So they had to go with Micah Parsons. They already have depth at linebacker, but he was still one of the best defensive players in the draft, so still a good pick. And they addressed defense in this draft. They got a lot of defense, so it's what they needed.
I'm gonna give the Cowboys an A. I think trading back out of, they had the 10th pick, because Surtain went right before they're about to go, and I'm pretty sure they would have taken them. So I like that they traded back and they were able to get a defensive piece where they really needed people. So I like the Parsons pick, and then right after that they went for corner, and the rest of the draft they're pretty much just going all defense, which obviously everybody was frustrated about, all their fans were last year, because that's pretty much why they lost every game they lost. So I think they did their front office did a pretty good job drafting.
For the Broncos, I gave them an A. They went Surtain in the first round. That defense, that secondary especially, is going to be great. They have a lot of good players there, and they got a good young running back in the second. I liked him a lot, and they addressed their offensive line too. I think it was a pretty good draft.
I'm gonna give the Broncos an A minus. Obviously, Patrick Surtain was regarded as the best corner in the draft. I think they should have tried to get a quarterback. I actually don't know why they didn't. So they might be planning something in the future. Javonte Williams, great addition for them after losing Philip Lindsay. And the rest of the draft, they're pretty, like, nothing like huge for them, but again, just filling up depth, and their defense could definitely be top, I'd say easily top 10 next year, possibly top 5.
I give the Lions a B plus. I think that they got Sewell at a great value at 7. They're actually very lucky that he fell to them, and they really just got every single position that they needed in the draft. They had a pretty good draft.
I'm gonna give the Lions a B. They're actually fortunate for them that Penei was able to drop to 7. I didn't think there's really a chance he would drop out of the top 5, but that was a very solid pickup for them. And they got Amon-Ra St. Brown in a couple rounds later, which was another one of their better picks. But other than that, they didn't have too many picks. So, I mean, Penei was mainly their only guy. They have no receivers other than Amon-Ra right now, really. So, hopefully, they'll do some stuff in the offseason to help them out a little bit.
For the Packers, I gave them a B plus. I think, especially with the Aaron Rodgers situation, that they should have gone offense in the first round to try to please him a little bit to help that decision. But Eric Stokes isn't a bad pick in the first round. They got a steal with them with Amari Rodgers in the fourth round. Great pick for them. And they got their next center with Corey Linsley leaving, so it's a pretty good draft.
Packers, I'm giving them an A. Eric Stokes, I think, is a really good pickup for them because they've lacked speed in their secondary for so many years. So he could definitely be like a big playmaker like that. And they got their new center replacing Linsley. Amari Rodgers, that was a very good move for them trading up to get him. And then after that, they were just, again, like most teams, just filling up depth. Actually, the corner they drafted, Shamar Jean-Charles, he was actually ranked the 16th best player in college football, and they got him at, what, 178. So that was kind of a steal right there. But yeah, and with all like the Aaron Rodgers stuff going on, I think they did a really good job just sort of blocking that out and just executing.
I gave the Texans a C minus. They didn't have any picks for the first two rounds, so they already can get a pretty good grade. But their first pick, picking a quarterback, I know there's the Watson situation, but I don't really think that quarterback is going to be good at all. And their other picks are just really positions that they already had. So I think they had a pretty bad draft.
I'm gonna give the Texans a D minus. I mean, that's probably one of the worst drafts you could possibly have. The quarterback taking their, so is he a second? No, he's a third round pick. Their first pick in the draft is third round pick, and then they take a quarterback when they already have Deshaun Watson. Even if Deshaun left, no one even knows who this guy is anyways. So, and then after that, Nico Collins. I was a Nico Collins and Brevin Jordan were actually pretty good picks, but other two guys, again, were pretty much nobodies. And the reason they didn't have their first or second round pick was because they traded for Laremy Tunsil with the Dolphins. And again, that was just a dumb trade it by the end of it. Easily the worst draft out of anybody.
I give the Colts a B plus. I think their first two rounds they did great. Those are great picks, but as they got deeper in the draft, I think they made some questionable picks like Sam Ellinger in the fifth round. That was a pretty trash pick.
I'm gonna give the Colts A minus. So I thought they were gonna take I thought they were gonna go receiver in the first round. If you watched our mock draft, which you should go watch that, pretty interesting video. But they addressed their D line with their first two picks. Kwity Paye is gonna most likely make an immediate impact for their already really good defense. But I mean, yeah, really. After those first two, they got another tight end, Sam Ellinger, maybe one of the worst picks of the draft. They got a wide receiver late, which could be good. I don't know too much about him. And then they got O-line. So again, there wasn't really much to address for them. So I think they filled what they really needed to do.
I give the Jaguars an A. Obviously, they can't have that low of a grade when they have Trevor Lawrence, but questionable pick with Travis Etienne. I know that they were college teammates, but you already have James Robinson. He's a great running back at a low value. But later in the draft, they did some pretty good jobs going offensive line, corner, DN. They really to try to help that defense.
Jaguars, I'm also going to give an A. Obviously, they got T-Law. The reason that I don't have them having an A plus is the Etienne pick. Obviously he's a player, but they have James Robinson. They just signed Carlos Hyde, so I just don't really get that much. They way bigger needs to fill their running back. Tyson Campbell, very good corner for the second round. They got Walker Little for their O line as well. Rest, they're just filling up some depth needs, and they also got Dylan Moses after the draft, which if he can stay healthy, that's going to be really good for them too.
I give the Chiefs an A. They didn't have a pick in the first round, but with their second round pick, they went linebacker, which is one of their needs, so I like that pick. They got Creed Humphrey, which was actually, he fell surprisingly. That was a great value pick for them there. And really, they just drafted pretty well, so it was a good draft.
Oh, I'm gonna give the Chiefs an A minus. They did good with what they had. They got the linebacker Nick Bolton in the second round, and they also got Creed Humphrey, which is, again, they're just building up that really good O-line now, actually, for Mahomes. And the rest, not that much else. But again, they're another team that doesn't really need like a ton of stuff, and they definitely addressed what they needed to.
I'm gonna give the Raiders a B. They reached on their first round pick. He wasn't even the top three tackle at that point, but I like their second round pick, Trayvon Moehrig. He's actually really good. But really, besides that, and Divine Diablo, he's actually good. But besides those two picks, I don't really like anybody that they drafted.
I'm also going to give the Raiders a B. They definitely, again, they struggled with their first round pick like usual. Obviously, he's a good player, but definitely did not have to take him that early. Moehrig was a really good pickup for them. And then the rest, they were just helping out their defense, which is what they need most. So, again, a pretty fairly average draft for the Raiders.
They got Asante Samuel in the second. He's actually a really good corner. And Trey McKitty, tight end. That fills their hole when they lost Hunter Henry. So that was actually a really good draft by them.
Now, I'm gonna give the Chargers an A. Rashawn Slater. Lots of people actually think he's better than Penei, so if that happens to be the case, that's gonna be a pretty much a steal at 13. Asante Samuel, the corner was definitely a position that they need, and they addressed that. Picking a wide receiver, I also didn't really understand. Tight end, they lost Hunter Henry, so that he could potentially be good there. And the rest, they were just helping out their O-line more and defense.
I give the Rams an A minus. They didn't have any first round picks, but with the second round, with their next pick, they went with Tutu Atwell, very, very good speedy wide receiver. It's gonna be a good target for Matthew Stafford, and they really loaded on the back of the draft. They had a lot of great picks, just filling all their holes, so it's a pretty good draft.
I'm gonna give the Rams a B plus. Again, yeah, they didn't have the first round draft pick because they've pretty much traded all of them away like forever. And they got Tutu Atwell, which is definitely gonna help their offense. He's more of like a speedy gadget guy. And they went two more wide receivers in the later rounds, which very questionable. But other than that, they were just pretty much helping out their depth. Seemed like they're kind of taking the best player available at whatever position they were taking. So, decent draft, nothing special.
I give the Dolphins an A. I think Jalen Waddle, a lot of people thought that they should have gone O-line, but I think he's the best wide receiver in the draft, so that was a great pick for them there. Obviously, their next first round pick, they went Jalen Phillips, very, very good edge rusher. Like their first three, four rounds, like Liam Etchenberg later in the draft, that was a great pick too. I think they just hit on all their draft picks. I think they have really good draft there.
I'm going to give the Dolphins an A as well. Jalen Waddle, I didn't agree with the pick, but again, he's obviously a really good player that can make plays happen. So after that, Jalen Phillips, that's huge for their D-line. And then Javon Holland, good for their secondary. Liam Eckenberg. Yeah, they did good on a lot of their draft picks. So I think they had a pretty productive draft. But I just didn't think the Waddle pick was the best
I give the Vikings an A. I think they did a great job in the first round, trading back and still getting the guy that they wanted. I don't know about their next pick, Kellen Mond. I'm guessing they're trying to build for the future. But yeah, and I think Wyatt Davis that late in the draft was actually a really good steal, so they had a pretty good draft.
I'm also gonna give the Vikings an A. That was huge for them actually trading back and still being able to get Darrisaw. Kellen Mond, I do not understand at all. But after that, Chaz Surratt, good for their linebacking core. Wyatt Davis, they really went heavy on O-line, I think. Wyatt Davis, they got. The running back choice, I don't get. But other than that, they had a solid draft.
Patriots, I gave them B plus. I didn't like the Mac Jones pick. I know they wanted a quarterback. I thought that they were gonna trade up if Fields was still at 8, but they just waited, and they got Mac Jones. I think he's a bust, so I don't think that was a good pick. But their later rounds, Ronnie Perkins, that was a great pick, and Joshua Bledsoe, that was a steal that late in the draft, so it wasn't that bad.
I'm gonna give the Patriots an A minus. I'm also not too high on Mac Jones, but I think he can fit, if Belichick can, if they can like morph him into what they really want him to be, then could definitely start building up somewhat of what they used to have. And Christian Barmore, great for their defense, and Ronnie Perkins, that's both big D-line picks. Other than that, I mean, the free agency that they had was insane, so. They didn't really need to, and they weren't in desperate need of all these players, but yeah, they did good for the first couple rounds.
For the Saints, I gave them a C plus. I don't think they hit on a single pick in any pick that they made this draft. I think Ian Book was a trash pick. He's really not talented at all at quarterback. So I just think that it was a pretty trash draft.
Gonna give the Saints a C. They did not. Now there's like people trying to defend this pick, the first round pick. They got a defensive end. There's people trying to defend it. Sure, you can say like, oh, it's a wake up call for Marcus Davenport or whatever, but there's just so many more needs on that team than trying to like spark Marcus Davenport basically. And then their second round, they got a linebacker and they already have DeMario Davis. So obviously that's not. They need a second linebacker, but again, not their biggest need. They drafted Paulson Adebo in the third round, which I think that's really their best and only good pick. And then after that, it's just kind of an embarrassing draft.
I gave the Giants a B plus. I think that trading back was actually a pretty good move, but I don't agree with who they picked. Tony's a really great player, but they signed Galladay. They got John Ross. They already have Slayton and Shepard. I don't think they really needed a wide receiver. I do like their second round pick. I think he was a really underrated outside linebacker. He's gonna fit well for them, but it was a pretty average draft.
I'm gonna give the Giants a B minus. Kadarius Toney is a great player, obviously, but yeah, like you said, but they just have too many wide receivers, especially with signing Galladay. And then Uzulari, that was definitely a great pick for them. And then other than that, not really much to say.
I give the Jets a B plus. I think the Zach Wilson pick, that was pretty good. They believe that he's their guy. I think he's pretty good, so we'll see how that turns out. I do like the Elijah Vera Tucker pick. That was also a good pick. Trading up for him was definitely a need. And then Elijah Moore, getting him that late was also a really good pick. Michael Carter, another good pick, but like later in the draft, they really just started missing on these picks, so just the first couple picks were good, but besides that, it was pretty average.
I'm gonna give the Jets an A minus. They got their franchise quarterback, which they've really been needing for a long time. And after that, they got Elijah Vera Tucker, just one of the most underrated linemen in my opinion in the draft. They got Elijah Moore. Wide receiver wasn't necessarily something that they like desperately needed, but He's a great player, and he should be able to make a pretty significant impact next season. Running back Michael Carter. I'm actually glad they didn't like. I'm glad they didn't go like first round running back, because running back's obviously one of the most like replaceable positions, and so they got a solid prospect there. And yeah, the rest are just not really that much to say, but they had a very good turnaround draft for them.
I gave the Eagles an A. I think trading up for DeVonta Smith, that was a great pick right there. They need a wide receiver. Hopefully he can be their guy. Going O-line in the next round, I like that. And then they really just loaded up in the back half. That had really good picks, a great value. I think it was a pretty good draft.
I'm gonna give the Eagles an A minus. They're notorious for drafting bad wide receivers, and really think it's unlikely that DeVonta Smith's gonna be a bust. So that was a very, very smart move there to trade up for him. They helped out their O-line right after, D-line right after that, and then their secondary. So very solid first couple picks there. Running back, not necessarily the best, but yeah, after that they really went heavy on their D line, so they had a solid draft.
I'm gonna give the Steelers an A minus. I do not like Najee Harris in the first. I don't think that going first round running back was the way to go with that. And second round tight end, that was also very questionable. But really, besides those two picks, I like the back half of their draft. They went O-line and linebacker, two positions that they need. And they really, and I also like the punter in the last round, so they get an A for that.
I'm gonna give the Steelers an A minus also. Again, I don't really agree with drafting running backs in like the first, definitely not the first round, and not really the second round either, unless it's something like really special. But Najee Harris is obviously a very good running back, and he'll definitely make an immediate impact for the Steelers. And taking Pat Freiermuth in the second round, I'm not really sure what's going on with Ebron, if he's still gonna be there or not. But again, that was kind of a reach right there. And then they did go center, which was smart for them in the third round. And then after that, they were definitely helping out their linebackers. They got Ross Shea very late in the, that's either the fifth or sixth round. And yeah, they had a pretty good draft. Just reached on a few picks, but got a lot of good players.
I'm gonna give the 49ers a B plus. People thought they were gonna go Mac Jones with the third overall pick, but they ended up going Trey Lance. I think that was a good move because Mac Jones is gonna suck. And going guard second in their second round pick, also really good. I like Trey Sermon too, but I think that they reached on a couple picks in the later rounds, but it was still a pretty solid draft.
I'm gonna give the 49ers an A minus. Trey Lance, way better than Mac Jones. I'm not glad they took him, but like, it would have kind of been embarrassing if they would have taken Mac Jones third pick in the draft. But after that, they helped out their O-line. Trey Sermon was actually a really good pick for them, even though it's a running back. They lost Breida last year, and then they just lost McKinnon, so he'll definitely be a replacement, make a big impact for them. And yeah, the rest they were just pretty average, but they got their and again, I don't know what's happening with Garoppolo and who's gonna start or whatever, but they're in a pretty good spot to, if they can stay healthy, they're in a pretty good spot to go back to the playoffs.
I gave the Seahawks a B minus. Kind of hard to rate them good when they only had three picks. And with their historically bad defense, they still went with wide receiver with their first pick, which is not even close to one of their needs. So I didn't like that. I liked going cornerback though, and tackle. Those are two good picks, but with three picks is not really much you can do with that.
Yeah, I'm gonna give the Seahawks a C. Three picks, not much you can do. There's really not much to expect. Wide receiver pick does not make sense, and the corner pick was actually a really good pick for them. That's the only reason that really saved this draft, because secondary is definitely their weak point, and O-line as well. So they did okay with the picks that they had, but again, just not really productive.
I gave the Bucks an A minus. Obviously, they re-signed their full roster, and they just won the Super Bowl. So anybody they picked would just be for depth, basically. And they had the last pick in the first round. They went outside linebacker. I like that. Truscott in the second round. Good backup to Tom Brady. He could be their future. I don't know about that though. And really, just got some good depth picks in the later round. So be solid.
I'm gonna give the Bucks an A. Joe Tryon is great for their depth at linebacker, and Kyle Trask is potentially gonna be their quarterback of the future, and they have him sitting behind the greatest quarterback of all time for who knows how long. And right after that, they went O-line, and then they also got a couple more linebackers later, and they also got a cornerback in the 7th round. So he'll be good for depth again, but yeah, they didn't really necessarily need anybody. I thought they were gonna possibly trade a decent amount of their picks for like in the future years or whatever, but they did good for what they had.
I'm gonna give the Titans a A. I loved how Caleb Farley fell to them that late in the draft. That was a really good pick, and they need corner. And they went tackle and linebacker in the next 2 rounds. Those are also really good picks. Getting to the later rounds, they kind of reached on a couple picks, and I didn't like the Racy McMath pick, but besides that, I think it was a pretty good draft.
Titans, I'm gonna give them an A minus. Caleb Farley obviously gonna help out their secondary. They went O-line, and then after that it was a little sketchy. They got a corner. Actually, they got two corners including Farley, and then Des Fitzpatrick is a pretty good pick because they lost Corey Davis. Rashad Weaver is another great pick for their D-line, and they had a couple picks after that, not that much, but again, a productive draft for them.
I gave the football team an A. I like the Jamin Davis pick in the first round. They really had nobody that good at linebacker. He'll have an immediate impact for them. Samuel Cosmi falling that far to them in the second round. That was also a great pick. De'Ami Brown in the fourth round, another great pick. Towards the back half, I don't really know, but seemed like a pretty solid draft.
Football team, I'm gonna give them an A minus. Jamin Davis, solid first round pick there for the linebacking core. You got Sam Cosmi. They desperately need O-line, and that's gonna help them a lot. They drafted corner in the 3rd round, so that could he has a nice ceiling them for there, and he can help with their secondary. De'Ami Brown, solid wide receiver. And after that, they were pretty much just going depth. They actually went pretty heavy on their D-line towards the end, which I don't really necessarily understand because they're already known for having one of the best D-lines in the league. Chase Young, Matt Ioannidis, Jonathan Allen. So I don't really get that at all. But again, they had a really good draft for what they needed. In case you haven't noticed, in the last podcast, we had a new member, Yanni, and unfortunately, he was not able to make it for this podcast, but he did send us a few notes that he wanted to say, so I'm gonna read them right here. So said he was not surprised by the Bears trading up for Justin Fields. He's surprised by Owusu-Koramoah falling all the way into the 2nd round. And he thinks the Raiders reached on their 1st round pick, Alex Leatherwood, which I think pretty much everybody can agree with. Steelers should not have taken Najee Harris in the 1st round. Thinks the Jets had a great draft and improved on positions they needed. He's surprised that the Packers didn't draft an offensive player in the 1st round for Aaron Rodgers. And he said, not, quote, "not to be biased, but I think the Bears had the best overall draft." All right, thank you guys for listening again. These podcasts take a decent amount of time, so we appreciate the time that you give us to listen and take in our thoughts. And We're just also, if you haven't watched the last podcast we did, it was a full first round mock draft. We had three different perspectives of it, so you should definitely look at that. Yeah, if you enjoyed, please show your support, and I'm gonna let Ryan say a few things here.
Yeah, thank you for watching, of course. If you could subscribe, leave a like, give us feedback in the comments, that'd be great. Make sure you go to the links in the description, follow us on Instagram, follow the official Moth account, and thank you for watching.
Baby, tell me, how did you get so cold enough to chill my bones?